Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our canticle, O gracious life.
My child, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and years of life, your abundant welfare, they will give you. Do not let loyalty and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the table of your heart, so you will find favor and good repute in the sight of God and of people. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your path. Here's the first lesson.
Thanks be to God.
The hymn, Behold the Master Passeth By.
Thank you.
from the Word of God written in Matthew chapter 9, verse 9 to 13. As Jesus was walking along, he saw a man called Matthew sitting at the tax booth, and he said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. And as he sat at dinner in the house, many tax collectors and sinners came and were sitting with him and his disciples. When the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" But when he heard this, and he said, "Those who are well have no need for a physician, but those who are sick, go and learn what this means. I desire mercy, not sacrifice. For I have come to call not the righteous, but sinners." And so we read it.
Thanks be to God.
We don't stand and sing and not believe it.
Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Light in our darkness, Lord, we pray. And in your mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this life. For the love of your only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. O Lord, support us all the day long of this troublous life, until the shades lengthen and the evening comes, and the busy world is hushed. The feet of life is over, and the world is done. Then, Lord, be mercy, and as a safe country, a holy rest, and peace at last. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen.
But for divine grace,
We are gathered together once again to celebrate our Feast of Title. If God has spared us amid this rainy weather for almost all of us to settle down in church before the rain starts, we give glory to God for how far He has brought us and for granting us the grace to come together in worship as we celebrate our brother and friend Matthew. Praise be to God Almighty. Amen. I am once again so humbled to be the preacher for today. I am so grateful to the Lord Bishop, who is the mastermind of my being in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. He has dealt so well with me that I feel at home. I always introduce myself as a VC. I am proud to be part of the diocese. My Lord Bishop, God bless you. And I thank you, my fellow clergy, for accepting me to be part of you. My dean and all other clergymen, thank God for our lives that as filthy as we are, like tax collector Matthew, we have also been favored by divine grace to stand and speak for Christ. Fellow clergymen, God bless you all. My people, without you, our standing here will be nothing. The Lord be with you. If there is no one to respond and also with you, how can we move on with the word of God? But grace has brought you here so that the Lord who will be with you and I will speak to us as we go to the community with our renewed faith to spread the word of God and to build our church. Friends, before I start today, I have come very far from Friday. So I will just recap the top stories so that as I continue, it will not be as if I am showing a screen that no one understands. By divine grace, some of us were here on Friday and we start to base our trust in Christ on the faith of that boy's father, according to Luke chapter 17, who trusted so much in the disciples that he brought an epileptic son to them. They tried their possible best, but nothing could happen. When they have exhausted all their powers and they wouldn't do anything, this man did not lose faith. He waited on Christ, who was on the mountain praying. And when Christ Jesus joined the crowd, he went to him and said, "Sir, have mercy on my son. For when he is on fire, he can do so many wondrous things that can end his life." I spoke about his faith, and I spoke about the faith of the disciples. Whereas they did not give up, like some of us. When we cannot handle it, then we want to give up. We want to say it is over. If I cannot do it, then no one can do it. But the disciples, after that scene, went closely to the master. "Lord, how come we were not able to do it?" And Jesus said to them, as well as he said to the crowd, "If you have a faith like the mustard seed, just the mustard seed, you can move mountains." Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And I concluded by telling my people that, look, that faith of mustard seed would only work if you plant it. If you hold the faith in your hands,
and you do not dig the ground to put that mustard seed there, it will be waste. Because until and unless you plant it, water it and it germinates to be the greatest of tree, you are wasting your time. And I challenge the people, as I challenge myself, that here in the gathering of Christ, that is where most of us will be tormented. And when you are tortured, when you are tormented, give glory to God that He has chosen you to suffer like Christ. One day, He will glorify you with that little faith as the mustard seed. Amen. Amen. God is good. And all the time. So today, I will start from my sister Linda, as we all join together and sing a common song that this lady propounded. I love this song so much so that almost everywhere I go, I will quote a part of this song. The God of the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He will make them right. We have the hymn, the choir have that hymn. So we will join our hearts together and sing.
Thank you.
not disappoint me. I chose you, and I can tell thee, if you have the opportunity to be in the cathedral, my dear, they won't sing more than your choir, but they will sing just like your choir. They are so good. They are so good. Friends, come to Matthew, our patron saint. Matthew, in his time, like some of us today, has been painted black. Because of the kind of job Matthew does, people hate him with passion. They just don't want to see tax collectors because they are enemy to the Jews. Therefore, somebody like Matthew to be favored by Christ Jesus is questionable. And so from our reading, you realize that when they were at table eating, the same Pharisees came again. The same Pharisees came again. And this time, they did not go to Jesus Christ, but they went to the disciple. Why is your master eating with sinners and tax collectors? Friends, our theme for today is renewing our faith, reaching out to the community. For our faith to be renewed, we have to see ourselves as one. We cannot claim superiority over others, whereas we are the same people. If we want to choose to be Pharisees, then we will always worry ourselves with what is happening to Christians. That is Christ and his people. You have come to eat. They are also there to eat. So what is your problem? By the way, you did not throw the feast. It was this same Matthew that you have tagged black that has thrown the feast in his house. And you are present to partake. So what is your problem? My dear, this is what some of us are in the church of God. Everything that happens, we have to complain. Yet, we will not stand to do it. And when others are doing it to their best, all we can do is to dampen their spirits. Today, Matthew is calling on you and I to be aware that the Pharisees are with us. Instead of concentrating on them to lose faith, instead of concentrating on them to start doing the work of God in good shape, Christ is encouraging you that he has come because of you and I. Those of us who are not well, those of us who are sick, the chief of sinners, we are the reason he came. So let the complainant hurry up and go to the farthest extent to complain. Besides, we cannot stop them from complaining. They will always be there to torture us with their complaints. But as a renewed mind, as Paul would tell the Romans, transformed by the Spirit, let us hold on to Christ and serve Christ in humanity. My dear, remember what the epistle of John is telling us? We cannot love the Lord God in heaven and hate our own human beings. We are chief of hypocrites. And I like to qualify it as religious hypocrisy. When we come to religion and we are worshiping, our level of hypocrisy is too high that some of us see ourselves as the boss and others as the trash. It is my prayer that this afternoon you will renew your mind, that the least of the congregants and the highest of the clergy are one in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes. Therefore, when the leader is calling us to confess our sins, when we have finished confession, and the leader is calling us, the president, the celebrant is telling us to greet ourselves, one another, with a kiss of peace, we have a saying. We
are the body of Christ. And in one spirit, we have all been baptized into one body. Equality is what Christ is calling on us. Besides today's gospel, according to St. Luke, the story of Lazarus and the rich man. Even in hell, the rich man is seeing Lazarus as that dirty guy who sits at his gate. So he is still begging that Abraham should send him to go and dip his water, hand in water, and give to him. How on earth can some of us see ourselves more than human beings? My dear, be conscientized that soon our generation will fade and pass away. And you know where we are all going to meet? In the first place, at the grave. And after the grave, what you and I have done for Christ and His church will lead us either into heaven or hell. We have a common place to go and a common room to live in, the casket. So no one is above the other. The God on the mountain is still God in the valley. So the fact that you have your house built so well on the mountain doesn't mean you should look down on those in the valley. For the God of the day is still God in the night. Hallelujah. Matthew is calling on us today, charitably, to see ourselves and to aid one another and to celebrate the kingdom of God as we give glory to God. Amen. Friends, to move to the community is what some of us are really lacking. And on that, the last Friday, I touched one of the salient points that all of you seated here are looking at the priest. And I challenge you, how much more can the priest do than all of us combining our powers to go into the community? You will realize that in no time, we will be able to conquer all the community than to leave it on one person. And if the person is trying his best, all we can do is to criticize. He is always with the rich. He is going to where he can get ends meet. But when he comes to you, when she comes to you, you don't receive them. You don't receive us. So how can we come to you? We are taken by command. Jesus said, if you go and they receive you, stay there. My dear people of God, we have to build our church. And if we have to build our church, we have to derobe ourselves from pride and take up the mantle and follow Christ. Amen. In going to the community, a story was told about one of the white ladies who is so interested in racism. But she met one black lady that transformed her mind. So to speak, that she will not even think of racism again, but humbly embrace everybody. Because if the Lord has sent you, you should rather be a savior than to destroy. What happened? A community like Biabou is an estate. And so everybody is enjoying the estate facilities. The whole of the community are full of white people. The elite and the rich. One fine morning, this young, vibrant white lady, having done all her chores, went to her porch. And fortunately for her, she glanced on a white young lady like her, so beautiful, black lady like her. She is white, and the lady is black. So she said to herself, how come? Who rented this apartment to this black lady? Look, sometimes when things are happening, we have to really pause and praise God. This woman said to herself, if nothing at all, I will torment this black lady. till she moves out of this facility. You know, she has said to herself, by all means, for my sake, that apartment must be empty if this black lady is the one going to occupy there. So what did she do? Every morning, before this lady will wake up, permit me, I know it's an abomination, but let me use that word, okay? By the morning, this white lady will throw shit bomb to that young lady's house. You know what shit bomb is, tutu, right? You call it tutu, you don't call it shit, so I'm sorry for breaking your rules. Friends, and the first time this black lady saw this thing in her yard, she stood still. And she was asking so many questions. Why this? But she said to herself, as a child of God, whatever comes to me, I will make good use of it. Hallelujah. Are we together?
Yes.
And so whilst continuously every morning, this white lady is dumping the tutu in the black lady's yard, she was using that tutu for a good thing. In no time, the black lady realized that for about 3 days now, when I wake up in the morning, there is no tutu around. And so she began to ask herself, what is happening? Because she realized who was throwing the tutu. She knows now that it is the right white lady. A week passed, and the tutu was not coming again. My dear, we have to go to the community. They will throw stones at us. They will give us name. They will paint us black like Martin. But as Christians, as we are, we have to let them know that we know Christ. So after a week, the tutu stopped coming. So this lady challenged herself and said to herself, no, I have to go and check on this lady why the tutu is not coming, because I am enjoying the tutu. Are we together? So whilst she was going to visit this white lady, she was telling herself, would I be welcome? If I go there, okay, whatever she does to me, I decide to go, so I will take it in good faith. She went and knocked at the door. She heard a small voice. The door is open, come in. When she went in, this white lady was lying down, very sick. And that is the reason why for the whole week, there is no sheep bone. Are we together?
Yes.
But amazingly, she went with a rose flower. Hands at the back, she went to the young lady and said to her, could you please permit me to visit you? This lady could not utter a word. It's a long time I heard of you, so I have come to see what is going on, and I brought this rose flower for you. The white lady was shocked. She asked herself, what is happening? Why have I treated you so evil as I can? And you come here to treat me with rose flower? To be frank with you, no one knows I am in this state. I never knew you realize I am in this state. But I can't tell how you got to know I'm in this state. By coming to visit, you brought a rose flower. God bless you. And the black lady said, the same God that you are asking to bless me is the same God that gave me that wisdom to use your tutu to plant flowers. So these flowers, the rose you cherish today, is from your own garden. The garden you planted in my yard has brought up these beautiful rose flowers. Sisters became sisters. And there was no racism again. What at all has the church done to you that you want to pack and go? Do you think you are packing because of the priest? You have the bone of contention with Christ. Whatever you think has happened, so they should take their church. The church belongs to God and Christ Jesus.
Amen.
So if you want to go, you are not leaving the church. You are detaching yourself from Christ. The sheep bomb will be thrown at you anytime. They want to humiliate you because they have no sense. They want to tell you that you are not fit to be here. Instead of cursing your stars, use that same to do. Then one day, they will benefit from it. We are going into the community. Some of us are so reluctant that as we go into the community, we don't want to go because they know us. And when they see us in church clothes, they will marvel. Because every morning they see us cursing. So when we are marching, you give excuses and you stay with the old in the church. Because when your own people see you, they will be asking questions. Is she also in church? Is he also in church? We have to emulate Christ. We have to exhibit the love of Christ. We have to tell the people we have been saved. And they also need that Savior, Jesus Christ. Who is throwing what at you? Why are they throwing at you? You don't know. But if not because of this black lady, that white lady will stay in the room and die. Sometimes, some people are torturing and tormenting you. I remember one day, Jesus called Marty. Simple words, follow me. And he left collecting tax to follow Christ. Amen. Have you come to follow Christ?
Yes.
So why are you listening to everything? Are you the only person with ears? And let me tell you, whatever you do, people will talk. So when they are talking, let it be to praise the Lord God on high. I told them on Friday that I don't care what key I sing because my key is not on the organ, it's not on the guitar. I sing key Z. But I sing to glorify God, not human being. If my voice is not good to you, it's up to you. The one who gave me the voice is whom I am singing to glorify. Let us together renew our faith that how we are setting traps. And we are hoping that those who have done same to us will fall in that trap so they will see what prepared is. Let us stop that. Rather, use the sheep bomb they are throwing to us to plant rose. So when they are in need, we will visit them with the rose flowers. And God will bless us. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm Thank you. Almighty and ever-living God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, hear our prayers for this parish family, strengthen the faithful, arouse the careless, and restore the penitent. Grant us all things necessary for our common life, and bring us all to be of one heart and mind within your holy church, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, by your grace, you have called us in this diocese to a goodly fellowship of faith. Bless our Bishop Leopold and other clergy and all our people. Grant that your word may be truly preached and truly heard, your sacraments faithfully administered and faithfully received. By your Spirit, fashion our lives according to the example of your Son, and grant that we may show the power of your love to all among whom we live, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, our Governor, bless the leaders of our land, that we may be a people at peace among ourselves and a blessing to other nations of the earth. To our Governor General Susan, Prime Minister Ralph, Leader of the Opposition Godwin, members of the Cabinet and all in administrative authority, grant wisdom and grace in the exercise of their duties. To the members of the Senate and the House of Assembly and those who make our laws, give courage, wisdom and foresight, provide for the needs of all our people, and to fulfill our obligations in the community of nations. To the judges and officers of our courts, give understanding and integrity, that human rights be safeguarded and justice served. And finally, teach our people to rely on your strength and to accept their responsibilities to their fellow citizens, that they may elect trustworthy leaders and make wise decisions for the well-being of our society, that we may serve you faithfully in our generation and honor your holy name. For yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head above all.
Amen.
And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with this village, all who live and walk here and pass through here, now and evermore.
Amen.
The shepherd made his supper, Lord, and I shall be clean.
Wash me to the right hand of the Lord. The shepherd made his supper, Lord, and I shall be clean. And wash me to the right hand of the Lord.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Devon to us a memorial of thy passion. Grant us this day for the benefit of the sacred mystery of thy body and blood, that we may ever receive within ourselves the fruit of thy redemption. Who livest and reigneth world without end.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Sister Rodney to come forward and give his thanks, please.
Thank you.
to back with. Where began my ministry at the parish priest. Today, I realized I'm not as young as I used to be. I was here this morning to the Mass at 7. I went back down into town and came back up. Now I realize I'm not as young as I used to be. it's a pleasure to be here with you. I'd like to encourage you to continue to be faithful in your commitment and service to God as you work along with Dean Nichols and the presence of Deacon Ali and the lay minister and Deacon Obaro and the lay ministers and PCC and the various congregations. We continue to work together. We did not have any Patronal festival for some years because of the COVID-19 pandemic. But the restrictions have been eased up, the protocols, etc. And so we are able now to assemble again the full church and to have our Patronal festival for which we give God thanks. As a church, the diocese, we accept that we can resume communion in both kinds on the first Sunday in October to the second, but still that we still pay attention to those who are most vulnerable. Some still feel it necessary to wear masks and so to receive communion in one kind. We still pay attention to that, and also the greeting of peace. We'll have to monitor the amount of infection is very low at this time. We still have to monitor and see what happens as we move forward. So we give God thanks that we are able now to resume in this way and hope by God's grace that we'll be able to continue for a long time or forever without having to stop. So once again, thank you, and may God's blessing be with you. I ask your prayers as we assemble for, prepare to assemble for Diocesan Synod in St. Lucia from the 9th to the 13th of October. Traveling days is probably on the 8th and return on the 14th. We ask your prayers as we prepare to assemble. Thank you. God bless.
Session number 426.